Hi Leo, Rosemary from Rosemary Astrology, and welcome to your July 2024 astrology. So let's start with your ruling planet, the Sun. The Sun until the 22nd is going to sit in your 12th house. Remember, that's very much a hidden place in our chart. It has to do with our internal health, our psychological well-being, our soul health. There's an idea of isolation with the 12th house. It's where we go when we want to check in with ourselves, to get quiet. It is also the place where we have all those subconscious patterns where we explore things or think about things that we don't really want to share with others, things sometimes we're ashamed of, or fears we don't really want to admit to anyone. So the Sun transiting through there for the first 3 weeks of July is really a time of shining a really bright spotlight in those dark corners of the subconscious, maybe taking inventory of what your past year has been like, preparing for the coming year when the Sun moves into your sign and it is, you know, your birthday month and the start of your new year. Maybe seeing what you want to leave behind, maybe really searching patterns that have been tripping you up. This is sometimes, we say this is the house of hidden enemies. It is sometimes where we're our own worst enemy, I often find. So it also includes all those practices to do so. So maybe, you know, you are meditating, maybe you're doing dream work, for example. And there is a new moon there on the 5th at 14 degrees of Cancer. Just echoing that again, remember, a new moon is a great time to start something. It is, you know, often by the same token, you know, the time when we're ending something. So I'm going to start doing something this way or looking at things this way. And, you know, by the same effect, we're going to stop doing things a certain way. So the moon just adds, you know, to that energy of looking inwards. And you know, just again, you're going to be having that feeling of wanting to withdraw, wanting to be alone. You're not going to want to socialize as much. You might even be, you know, a little bit secretive as to what is going on because you really are looking inwards. And as I said, the moon is just adding to that, you know, inner subconscious self. And adding to that some more, of course, the Sun is going to trine Neptune sitting in Pisces from the 19th to the 22nd, just before the Sun leaves for your sign, exact on the 21st. And again, you know, a trine is an energy of flow. Neptune brings that energy of otherworldliness, of, you know, what lies below the surface of what we get in touch with, not using our rational mind, but, you know, through things like dream work. It sounds repetitive because the 12th house is related to the sign of Pisces and Neptune is the modern ruler of Pisces. So again, you know, the message is repeating for you, Leo. You know, I wrote The Call of the Dream, but the idea of what is intuitive, creative, very compassionate as well. So, you know, if you have been exploring this area, if maybe there's, you know, an issue in that area where you seem to be tripping yourself up, the solution might emerge as something you didn't rationally think of, you know, or something you didn't see, you know, with the rational mind. It's going to involve maybe just feeling or just intuition, you know, even the idea of dream work, you know, asking yourself before you go to sleep that you're going to dream of a solution or you're going to, through a dream, get insight into what is going on with you in terms of internal patterns and internal feelings. Neptune also rules spirituality and religion, so your beliefs may be guiding you as well. Neptune can also create confusion. So a trine is an easy, it's the easiest of all the aspects. The energy flows really, really smoothly. In a way, I'm thinking, you know, in one sense, don't deceive yourself, but this might be also insight as to where you deceive yourself, you know, and or where we can sometimes get lost. There's an energy of getting lost as well with Neptune. So for those few days, you might be really, you're almost getting lost in this sea of subconscious, but do know with the Sun there, you know, you are going to be able to get a lot of insight and a lot of focus as well. Just to sort of, I think what I'm trying to say is don't go off on some, you know, really extreme tangent or get really, really lost in some deep, deep aspect. But do know, you know, the answers are going to come through more meditative, reflective dream work rather than trying to really think through it in a really logical and rational way. Just before the Sun leaves, also on the day when this trine to Neptune is exact, There is going to be a full moon in Capricorn. Usually I talk about that at the end of the videos, but I'm going to talk about it before because last month's, did I say new moon? I meant a full moon at the end, at, on the 21st. And I'm getting confused. I'm getting that blur of Neptune energy. But the moon was full in Capricorn at 1 degree of Capricorn on the 21st in June. It is going to be full at the last degrees of Capricorn, 29 degrees of Capricorn, so the last degree, but again on the 21st. So we're back to the moon and the emotions, and that's probably why I'm continuing, because I just want to continue this story. A full moon highlights, a full moon can mark completion. You know, maybe something did come up here and, you know, it's 2 weeks later, it's the full moon, and you really have tried to integrate that and it's on its way to becoming a habit. You know, maybe something you're really, really struggling to overcome and it's going to complete here. You know, really going to be on your way with doing away with, you know, a subconscious pattern or a subconscious pattern habit rather that is coloring the way you see things. This, of course, is, you know, workplace, workload, physical health, where we are of service and duty to others, even if it isn't in paid employment, it can be employees as well. This, as I said, is our emotions, our soul health, our inner well-being. So, you know, the back and forth here can be just finding the balance, you know, maybe not being able to show up so much for others because you are doing internal work, or maybe, you know, you are seeing a pattern here that is, you know, you're going to see applies to the way you show up to be of service to others. And the full moon is going to highlight that. Then by the 22nd, the sun is going to move into your sign. It's the start of your birthday month. You're feeling really energized. You're in, you know, a wonderful light. You've done all the inner work. You've faced all the issues. And now you're ready, you know, to go forth and to start your year. Mercury and Venus will already be there. I will talk about them. Mercury arrives on the 2nd, opposing Pluto, of course, upon arrival, because remember, Pluto is just sitting at those very, very first degrees, somewhere probably around 1 degree by now on its retrograde, on his retrograde, heading back into Capricorn this fall. Venus arrives on the 11th and does the same thing. Mercury opposed Pluto. Remember, this is your house of partnerships, committed partner, business partner, very, very tight one-on-one relationship. So a very, very close friend, a mentor. It is exes as well. It can also be rivals in the competition. Whatever sits across from us one-on-one and has influence on who we are. And of course, we do bring our individuality and our personality and ourself to these partnerships. Mercury opposed Pluto really creates an idea of intensity in what you say, in how you are thinking. Mercury likes to explore a lot of options, is very quick, but with an opposition to Pluto can really get focused on one thing. You really want your words to carry weight. This could be something, you know, a concept going on in the seventh house in relation to you in relation to the partnership, how you show up, what is going on here. Going to have you focused, as I said, quite intensely. It's only the 2nd and the 3rd. It isn't long, but it can create really a lot of exploring, you know, where the power lies. Is there a power balance? Is there a power imbalance? And as I said, Mercury likes to explore a lot of options, but here can get quite focused on one thing. You're not going to be thinking casually during those few days. You might be very, very caught up in what is going on within a partnership. Venus does the same thing, opposing Pluto, but from the 11th to the 14th. Now, remember, Venus is charm. It is all our relationships. It's love. It relates to money as well. So what we value by the same idea. But this can be, you know, Venus getting involved in power plays. And it can bring, again, an intense exploration of our relationships. It can bring up something that is hidden or dark. Remember, Pluto shows us what isn't working, or shows us the dark side or the underside. It can bring up, you know, what isn't working, or that dark side of a relationship, something that has to be addressed. It can be long-lying resentments. Also, again, not long, 11, 12, 13, 14, counting on my fingers, but 4 days. Try not to get caught up in that, but do know it is excellent energy to work through something in a relationship, you know, something that's sort of been nagging in the background. Now is definitely the time where it's going to come up and it's going to have particular significance in terms of, you know, where lies the power and control in a relationship and, you know, what the dynamics are. And as I said, what, you know, the underside or the not working side is, it's also in relation to what you value. So, you know, perhaps what you value in terms of self and what you value in terms of what's going on in a relationship. So again, another transit that doesn't last particularly long, but whenever we're talking Pluto, we're getting into a lot of intensity. Then, of course, after that moves off and the sun arrives on the 22nd, you are in a wonderful aspect, Leo. Again, the sun just bringing a lot of energy and vitality from the 22nd on for 1 month. You know, Mercury there, you know, making you very communicative, very quick-witted, and Venus just making you know very charming and diplomatic. Others are definitely, definitely drawn to you. So, you know, if you aren't involved in a relationship, I'm talking about committed partnerships. And, you know, this Venus-Pluto opposition could also intensify committed partnerships. But if you're not, definitely, you know, you are under the aura of Venus's charm. And if you do begin a relationship, especially during the Venus-Pluto opposition, there can be a very intense, almost obsessive quality to it as well. Now, nothing is perfect. Mercury does enter pre-retrograde shadow on the 17th. The retrograde itself is in August from the 5th to the 28th, but already in pre-retrograde shadow on the 17th. The retrograde is in your sign, Leo. It's going to begin in Virgo, but the retrogrades are in the fire signs this year, so will be mostly in your sign. This will lead to confusion in your communications. People aren't going to understand what you're trying to say. They'll say you're not clear enough. You'll say, well, no, you're just not paying attention. This is also our online profile. Mercury has everything to do with language, speaking, writing. By that idea, it has to do also with, you know, computer language. So you might be trying to do something online that has to do with your image, yourself, and that just isn't going to work, or you're going to be misunderstood, or there's going to be some sort of confusion. So just do know that already starts now in July. And finally, let's talk about Mars conjuncts Uranus sitting in Taurus from the 12th to the 19th, but exact on the 15th. The 10th sits square to us in the first. This is where we seek success. The idea of another rung on the ladder, awards, achievements, our status. It can be in terms of career or job, if that's where you are looking to succeed. It can be in another area as well, but the idea, as I said, of a visible marker, like an award, an achievement, a new title, something others can see. Square to the first, sometimes there can be an aspect of, you know, this is also people in authority, right? So those on a higher rung of the ladder above us, government authority, parental authority. And the idea of, you know, what do we have to do to get to these markers of success? You know, are there things I don't want to do? Do they not sit well with who I see myself as an individual? You know, sometimes the question of integrity can come into play. But I call the Mars-Uranus conjunction always rebel meets warrior. So remember, Uranus is sudden insight, thinking outside the box, innovation, breakthroughs, breakdowns, breakaways. Sometimes self-initiated, very much what I think tends to happen when Mars is conjunct, because Mars is very self-focused and very dynamic. Sometimes things that happen to us out of the blue, but always with the idea of forcing us out of the rut, out of a structure that has become too restrictive, you know, wanting us to evolve and, you know, move up and move on type of thing. Mars, very headstrong, very dynamic, can be very combative as well. So this is the idea that, you know, sudden insight into how you can achieve success that is really, you know, innovative and thinking outside the box, and you're going to act on it very quickly with Mars there. If there is something that has been restraining you or someone, you know, that you just can't seem to get ahead type of thing, there's always something coming up, or there's always someone above you that seems to have some reason that might not be directly. I'm thinking of so many, you know, situations in the workplace that I've seen, but, you know, oh, I can't because of this and that. But, you know, you sort of feel that, you know, well, if you really wanted to, you could type of thing. But I wrote in my notes, and I have to find it because I thought it was quite interesting. I was really reflecting on this energy, and this just came to me. But the idea of, You know, if the pot has been simmering, now the lid is going to fly off. So this can even be the energy of you saying, you know, I'm done with this. I'm out of here. I'm just not going to do this anymore. You know, you're holding me back, or I'm being held back by this situation. And, you know, again, the rebel energy of Uranus, right? I'm out of here. I'm done. I'm breaking free from this structure that is holding me back. So whatever it is, know that Mars will be the energy to pursue it intensely and to fight for it. It really gives an edge to Uranus. And Uranus isn't constantly doing this, but when Uranus gets triggered by another aspect, depending on the aspect and the planet, of course, but, you know, we're talking a conjunction, this energy just really, really melds together. And we have, you know, fiery Mars that just wants to do something. Mars wants to do something, often on a very physical level. So, you know, let's do something. Let's take action, right? Let's get something done. And Uranus is saying, boom, this is what you have to do. You know, this is the new way to do it. Or, hey, you know, when we say breakaways, I'm not doing this anymore, stuck in the same old rut. I've been around the block on this. I've done this too many times type of thing. So you get the idea of what's going on there. I am really, really always interested. This happens usually once a year, and I'm always really interested to see how it manifests for others and, of course, how it's going to manifest for me. I am a Taurus, interestingly. I sit square to you, Leo. And just quickly before I wrap this up, Neptune stations retrograde on the 2nd, joining Pluto and Saturn. As we head into the fall, all planets will, or the outer planets will start to station retrograde in the interpersonal planets. So I think the next is Uranus, and then Jupiter is going to station retrograde sometime. So we're going to move into a little more of a reflective review, replan, fine-tune phase, as opposed to, you know, full steam ahead. So just want to put that on your radar as well. So lovely, Leo, that is everything I wanted to tell you for July. Have a wonderful, wonderful month. Drop me a comment. Let me know if any of this resonates with you. Take care, and I will see you on the next one. Bye.